I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. A man who was working as a helper on a garbage truck was struck and killed early this morning in the town of Blooming Grove. It happened on Clove Road near Glenwood Road. Police say 24-year-old John Walsh of Chester was picking up recyclables when he crossed into the opposite lane of Clove Road and was struck by a vehicle driven by an Immigration and Customs Enforcement agent. Walsh was working for IWS Systems, and police say he didn't see the oncoming vehicle when he stepped out in front of it. Walsh was pronounced dead at the scene. The ICE agent is not facing any charges or tickets. Democrat Hudson Valley Congressman Maurice Hinchey took his ongoing battle over federal budget-cutting proposals to the city of Newburgh on Monday, where he toured the city's one-stop career center, a facility that could face the loss of funding as part of Republican plans to reduce the federal deficit. Hinchey says cutting $5.3 billion from the Workforce Investment Act would jeopardize employment training as well as job search and workforce placement programs now offered to area residents.
We're going to be fighting to maintain this job training circumstance here and other job training circumstances here in our region and across the country, because it is so critically important for all of these individuals, but also critically important for our community. It's critically important for the city here, critically important for the county, for the Hudson Valley, and it's critically important for the future of this country.
The One-Stop Career Center gets funding from several sources, but the director of the county's Employment and Training Administration says the loss of Workforce Investment Act funding would result in a reduction in staff and services.
Depending on how much it's cut, that's a good question. If it's eliminated, obviously we'd have a hard time even keeping the centers open or providing the amount of services that we currently provide. Depending on what the cut is would determine what we would do. There are a lot of people unemployed, a lot of people need these services, and if this funding does get cut, we would have a hard time providing those services to these folks.
In addition to Newburgh, there are one-stop career offices in Middletown and Port Jervis. Knob says they've served about 10,000 people so far this year. State police in Orange County say the suspects arrested in connection with a series of daytime house break-ins in the city of Middletown may also be responsible for a number of residential burglaries in the neighboring towns of Wallkill and Mount Hope. Police took into custody 29-year-olds Shannon Canoff and Lola Sees of the town of Wallkill and Middletown residents Richard Reggio and Christina Donato. All four face felony burglary charges for break-ins and theft of property from Middletown houses on Highland Avenue, Wallkill Avenue, and Sproat Street. In Washingtonville, the search is on for a less expensive way to upgrade the village's overcapacity sewer system. Mayor Kevin Hudson has refused to sign off on a $7 to $9 million sewer plant project, saying a cheaper option may be out there. The mayor's decision not to move forward puts the village at odds with state regulators and could result in DEC fines. Hudson says the village needs time to determine if a more cost-effective program of repairing existing sewer lines can be implemented. And it's not your normal Habitat for Humanity home build in the city of Newburgh. A house that's a part of their East Parmenter Street revitalization project will include lumber milled from the Christmas tree that stood at Rockefeller Center in New York City this past holiday season. Today, Habitat volunteers on site were getting a boost from employees of Random House. The company is publishing a book about the use of Rockefeller Center trees over the years in Habitat home projects throughout the region.
The book that I've just written that'll be out in September is called The Carpenter's Gift, and it's inspired by the annual donation of the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree, the most famous Christmas tree in the world, to Habitat. Since 2007, the tree's been taken down and milled into lumber that's been used to build a Habitat house, usually pretty close to where the tree itself grew.
Today we have our Random House volunteers here who are part of producing and publishing the Carpenter's Gift, which is about the Rockefeller Christmas tree and then its relationship to using the lumber for Habitat and the whole process of giving and continuing the gift and the actual process of what it means to help each other out and to support each other in building lives and homes.
In the past 11 years, Habitat for Humanity of Greater Newburgh has provided 47 homes in partnership with working families in need. This house, with Rockefeller Center Christmas tree lumber, will be completed, fittingly, by December. Well, fans and air conditioners will be in full operation over the next couple of days as uncomfortable weather has moved in. Tomorrow will be hot and humid, with temperatures reaching the upper 80s and low 90s. More heat and humidity on tap for Thursday, with the highs in the low to mid 90s. For the latest news and weather information, keep clicking back here at Record Online. And for a complete wrap-up of the day's events, pick up tomorrow's edition of the Times-Herald Record. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter. Thank you.